Who goes there? Who's there? Are you referring to me?
No! No! I still have so much to accomplish!
This one's dressed up fancy. Let's run through his pockets.
Picking the dead's pockets? Are you serious?
I've still a rent to pay. He's got no more responsibilities. What's this? Gold watch.
Beautiful it is. We fence it and share the takings.
I suppose we are undertakers. Now, give him an eve.
12 dreams for the Red Queen under crown of stone. 8 voracious beasts born from 8 restless nights. 4 nails piercing the flesh of the sinner. 1 prayer for the summoned called by this song. 'Tis perhaps the countdown to oblivion for the once proud city of London. 'Tis perchance her inhabitants' last dance alone to face death and pestilence. Confronted by the eerie and unknown, mortals became desperate for answers. A flock's flight makes for an omen, the falling of a star, a dire presage. Turning to priests for interpretation when there was no reason to be found. When religion failed, men turned to science. I saw them build such vain cities, crafting machines made for endless war. New questions flourished as old answers withered. What is darkness but lurking sun? What is wall but enslaved stone? What is glass but tortured sand? What is song but a call to arms? What is hate but jilted love? What is life but death pending?
Death. Since the apple was plucked from the sacred tree, mortality was believed to be God's punishment, a righteous snare to keep mankind from ascending to the stars. They were all so wrong. Death is not a wicked thing, nor some holy retribution. A true punishment would be to never know its sweet. Awaken from the harshness and be born once more.
sweet brother. What have you done?
Mary! Oh, no! Mary! Hold on! Please, hold on! Oh, God. Oh, no. Mary.
Mary. No.
No. No. No! Please, a moment, let me explain!
This is no place.
Maybe some of the locals saw him.
We have several patrols roaming the area.
They do not pursue me.
But they're looking for vampires, and they're most efficient.
They'll not relent until the killer has been identified.
I have a common objective, but I require...
Shh. I think someone is eavesdropping.
Are you certain? You might as well come in, whoever you are.
Slowly, vampire. Who are you?
I mean you no harm,
saith the vampire. Present yourself.
I need a word. With anyone.
Well, that's something I can do for you.
William was an honorable man. I could have saved him.
Mr. Hampton, are you in there?
We knew him well. Another lost soul, a kindred spirit.
Sir, listen to the sound of my voice. I'm a doctor. You're suffering from shock.
I must return to my flock. They'll stray without me.
Remember, certain Skulls are every bit as resistant as we are.
Who are you? What do you mean by Skull?
You truly are a newborn. I should have realized...
Wait. You are the woman from the bar. Are you... like me? Can you help me?
I believe, sir, I already have.
George and the Saints, you've solved the mystery of these terrible murders. Patience, good fellows, I've come to offer help. Just give me a moment to secure my boat. We can leave this awful place.
William was not the evil man they claimed. He was just taken by the thirst. He needed his drink.
This man requires medical attention. We'll see he gets to the nearest hospital.
No, please, I must tend to my fold. My flock needs me.
Yes. Go with a good Dr. Swansea. He's resourceful, and I'm sure he'll take good care of you.
You'd best come as well. The sun is soon to rise, and you'll need a place to rest.
I just need a moment. If I can learn something about what has happened to William, I'll be a step closer to understanding what happened to me. Where are we headed?
We're on our way to the Pembroke Hospital. It's just across the canal. They'll have a bed for poor Mr. Hampton.
William was... What manner of creature was he?
Predator, prey, villain, and victim. Who can say?
The important thing is that he's been stopped.
Duly noted. And the woman? What? Who is she?
What woman?
Oh, don't play me for a fool. You used me to locate that Skull. You must know who she is.
And I thought you a gentleman. You shouldn't talk about a lady behind her back. But I will tell you, she values her privacy. Were London as peaceful as she appears from the middle of the canal? If only that were the reality of the situation.
To be honest, I've always tried to avoid this part of town.
Pembroke Hospital is the last bastion between the rest of London and the epidemic. The flu has decimated the East End and the war still rages. Welcome to the front lines of a plague.
This is where you work, Dr. Swansea.
I am the administrator of Pembroke Hospital.
I thought you were here in service of your mysterious order, the Brotherhood of...
Of St. Paul's Stole, yes. But first and foremost, I'm a man of science. A physician, like yourself, Dr. Reed.
How do you know who I am?
No need for modesty. You are Dr. Jonathan Reed, a surgeon of some caliber and renown, if I'm not mistaken.
You are correct, sir.
I knew it! I had my suspicions. But when you took the blood sample from the corpse of poor William, I was certain. Dr. Reed, marvelous.
Have we met?
I attended three of your seminars before the war. I have the utmost admiration for your research. And what a turn of fate. England's most esteemed blood specialist returns to London a vampire.
That word, again, from a so-called man of science.
I understand. Traditionally, the role of science is to refute myth, but when myth walks among us, the Brotherhood of St. Paul has dedicated its purpose to their study. There's so much for you to learn.
Of that, you are right.
Well, then let me be blunt. Join my staff at Pembroke Hospital. As a physician. I suspect you'll not find a better post of employment to contemplate your predicament.
This is sudden. I was returning home to see my sickly mother. But alas, that was before contracting this affliction.
Dr. Reed, take a moment to consider. The post would be for the night shift, providing a good explanation for your absence during daylight hours. You'll be adequately reimbursed and have a place to hide. I even had the forethought to bring some clean clothes. So, what do you say?
It seems I have little choice, but yours is a generous offer, so I thank you.
Brilliant! Oh, Jonathan, this is one for the book, and the beginning of a beautiful friendship. Please, Jonathan, come in. Fascinating, is it not? In the last decade, so many mysteries have been brought to light with our microscopes. The human body, biology's penultimate frontier. The more we explore its boundaries, the less we're able to trace a clear line between life and death. You, my friend, have a foot in both countries. The view must be vertiginous.
It's at least as vertiginous as chatting about vampires with you, I would say.
This must be all so new to you. This area of town, the hospital, a brand new life. How stimulating it must be.
I wish I could share your enthusiasm, Dr. Swansea, but my condition defies scientific categorization. Undead? Unalive? Immortality defies logic.
I cannot express my thrill at this serendipitous turn of events. The world's most eminent specialist in blood transfusions, a vampire. One might say a gift from heaven.
The flu took my dear wife, Emily. I take comfort knowing we'll soon be together again.
Mr. Rainfield, that's no way to talk. You're in good hands here, and we'll be up again soon enough. Now do me a kindness and get some sleep. I'll be back round later.
Your words are kind,
the blessings of an angel. You're the sweet, sweet Lady of Mercy.
Good evening, Dr. Reed. It's a pleasure to see you again. You seem surprised. Dr. Swansea has brought me up to speed concerning your recent appointment to Pembroke Hospital.
You're a vamp. The lady who saved me that night, before vanishing into thin air. I remember you from the pub with Dr. Swansea.
Indeed. Allow me to introduce myself formally this time. My name is Lady Ashbury. I remember you well, in spite of the brevity of our encounter.
What? What? What is this? Who are you? Get out of my room.
There's no need for alarm, madam. I'm Dr. Reed, the new surgeon.
Preposterous. Dr. Reed, you say? I don't want some bumbling intern. Where's Dr. Swansea?
What? What do you want? Leave me alone.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reed. I'm looking for Nurse Dorothy Crane.
There is no Dorothy Crane here. Now, goodbye.
I'm afraid this medical leaflet says the opposite, sir.
Really? Well, I'm afraid I'm going to close this door right now. Go bother someone else, Mr. Doctor. A strange man was at the door with a pass for our medical facility. I refused him entry.
Darius, how could you know he didn't need our help?
His clothes were too finely tailored to be from Whitechapel.
Perhaps just the friend of that stray poet who is always about.
Richard Nidocott? No, not of the same cloth, this man. I suspect some machination from that journalist.
Clayton Darby. Is he still asking questions?
Yes. I saw him drifting around St. Mary's Church. I swear he is tracking me just downwind.
Wait. Stop this nonsense. I know Nurse Crane is here. Shall we speak man to man, you and I?
All right. Speak up.
Don't you see we're on the same side? We fight to help the poor, sick, and abandoned.
I'm nothing like you, Mr. Doctor.
Yes, you are. You too believe in providing medical care without charge. You know what we have to sacrifice to make the world a better place.
I have to admit your words have conviction. All right, I'll let you see Dorothea. Don't make me regret this, though.
I need help!
What do we have here, nurse?
Patient Razvan Vasily. High fever running on 3 days. Complaints of dizziness, muscle aches, head pain. Diagnosed with influenza.
Treatment?
Aspirin and salicin for the fever and discomfort. Liquids for dehydration. But he's having trouble keeping even water down.
Thank you, nurse. Anything else I should know?
He did lose consciousness this morning, but he's never had convulsions like these.
He's not convulsing. He's choking. He's not getting any air. Scalpel! Hand me that scalpel!
What can I do, Doctor?
I need to perform a tracheostomy. Short pipe. That rubber tube will do. We're going to cut a passage for air through the neck.
Yes, Doctor. He's breathing again, but he's coughing up blood.
Internal hemorrhaging. I need to make another incision into the chest cavity to drain the fluids from the lung. Prepare another tube.
A thoracostomy? Doctor, we've nothing to fight the infection. We need an aseptic environment.
Right then, Nurse Crane. What do you suggest we do?
I've no idea. I'm not the doctor.
Time is of the essence. We need to perform a thoracic drain.
Yes, Doctor. He's still bleeding, Doctor. I'm losing his pulse.
The drain must have punctured the intercostal artery. There's too much blood.
Are you all right, Doctor?
I...
I can't see. Yes. Yes. I have this knife. Allow me to finish the procedure alone. I need the room.
I'd prefer to stay and see this through. This is my patient, Doctor. I have needle and thread for stitching the wound.
Good. The stitches are holding. How's he doing?
We're losing him. We've lost his pulse. He's dying, Doctor!
Cardiac massage, now.
Cardiac... What? Are you making this up as you go along? We've lost the pulse. He's gone, Doctor.
Nurse, we did everything we could.
Truly? Everything you could? Is that how you'll report this in your log? Is this how the war went? Piling up one poor corpse beside the next?
This was not an influenza-induced seizure. I've never seen symptoms like these on the continent.
Neither have I. But the previous symptoms leading up to this attack were the same, indistinguishable from the epidemic.
No. It was something more vile in these reactions. Something primitive.
There have been numerous reports of mental breakdowns caused by the fever that accompanies the flu itself, Doctor.
Yes, but... I'd best take some samples of the blood for analysis. Your heart might be in the right place, but you can't carry on with this blackmail. For God's sake, Dorothy, it's extortion. It's a serious crime.
Doctor, you think your warnings scare me? I've stolen and plied, blackmailed and lied, but what else am I to do? I'm all these people have.
Nurse Crane, there is no question that the work you've done here is extraordinary. But this dispensary is incapable of coping with the outbreak. It's only a question of days before the situation at hand will overwhelm us. I cannot allow it. It's my duty to put an end to this immediately.
I'm not ashamed. I did what was right. For in the end, I saved lives and you took them. But we had so much in common, Doctor. Don't you see that?
I would ask you to avert your eyes, sir. Or did you not know it was rude to stare?
I knew it.
Speak up, Dr. Reed. I like a man who speaks.
Bid you farewell. For now, my lady.
I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. We commend unto thy hands of mercy, most merciful Father, the soul of our sister departed, and we commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Why kill my Mary? And stick her here in this cold, god-awful place.
These are the legal requirements for the epidemic, madam.
Oh, Avery, I feel so tired. Please take me home.
Yes, madam.
This is a nightmare.
Jonathan, there is nothing you can do but accept it.
What brings you here?
I thought you could use the company. I am so sorry for your loss. Good. But be careful.
What should I do then?
St. Mary's Church is not far from here. Go there and make your peace. Find the solace you need.
My lady wants me to confess.
No, Jonathan. It's you who wants to confess, I think.
God protect us. You've got a leech in the hospital.
Yes, my hospital. My mission is to heal while you go about warring.
You've set the table for a snake. I wonder why there's venom in your food.
I'm growing tired of your song. You're a woodsman, McCallum, not a doctor. Return to your hunt.
Remember, I've a good nose for machinations. I can flare the scent at a mile. You can't hide from the guard.
Leave him, Jonathan. This is sacred ground. Neutral territory. And I just had the carpet cleaned.
Have escaped the wrath of Ascalon for too long. It is time to purge the sewers of their filth.
You again? The one they call the sewer dog?
Hold your tongue, newborn, or I'll crush you like a maggot.
You've let the beast consume you.
Finally, a touch of lucidity.
What have you done?
Vicar Larrabee, what happened?
Demon! Hell Scourge! Son of perdition!
Vicar! Vicar! Jonathan is no demon. He's just a loving son returned from the dead. Like your Christ, Vicar.
Mary, it has been you all along.
Oh, it's me, all right. Precious brother.
Why did you lure me here?
I'm gathering the family. For a final reunion. All smiling, all dead. Thanks to the good Dr. Reed.
Mary.
Mother? Say hello to your son.
Hello, Jonathan.
Mother, I...
What do we have here, Mother? The prodigal son has lost his tongue. Our Jonathan. Always had the first and last word at dinner. The entertainer, the star of our show.
Mary, let me explain.
Shut up. It's my turn to do the talking. I have this nasty hole in my chest, Johnny. It needs to breathe.
Right then. Speak.
My prayers went so long. Without an answer. My husband, killed in France. My child, carried away by the flu. My brother, promising to return in his letters, then disappearing in thin air. I went from hospital to hospital, cemetery to cemetery, grave to grave. I've lifted every stone in London, searching for an end to the nightmare. And there you were, in front of me, on a dark pier.
It was the hunger. You know it now as well.
The joy to have finally found you. I longed for your arms, a final happy ending to so much tragedy, to tell me all would be well again. As you did when we were children. It was this filthy dock where you greeted your sister. I dug a tunnel from my grave with my fingers and teeth.
Mary, I had taken your life before I realized it was you. I tried to kill myself.
But you failed in your attempt. We cannot die, can we? We are a plague. I've watched you, Jonathan. You pull the strings and sever them.
I've done what I had to do. I did not choose this fate. But I will have my answers.
Ugh. There are no answers, Doctor. There's nothing left but pain and lies and treachery.
Mary, wait!
Time to go, Mother. Give my regards to my son.
No!
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 Can you imagine what I have in mind for you?
I'll destroy you!
Finally, we hear the truth! Dr. Reed, admit it. You're a monster who takes joy in killing, who relishes the chase, the secrecy of it all.
I'm still a scientist. I shall find a cure for this madness.
You lie to yourself. Confess your sins.
Over the slaughtered corpse of our mother!
Are those tears, brother dear? Your heart still bleeds with emotion. My dead heart has dried.
You are mad.
Oh, so that's what I am, Doctor. Mad? I was beginning to wonder. I've been hearing voices, one in particular. That of my dead brother. This is the reason I must kill you. Not for your betrayal. Not for our poisonous kiss. Not even for the lies you tell yourself. No. So that smooth and wicked voice will stop ringing in my head!
I cannot let you kill again, Mary.
Time to die, brother. And this time for good! Brother, it's time to bring this conversation to an end, forever.
You know I will not play this game.
Calm now, Doctor. Like a rabid dog. Or think you're performing an autopsy?
Don't be ridiculous.
I'll kill them all. The kind Dr. Swansea. The sweet little lass with hair of red. I am the harbinger, bringing your punishment.
Mary.
Don't you see? This is not me. Flesh that never ages. All nightmare, no dream. Bring it to a close. Let me sleep. At last, I can forgive you.
Thank you.
stricken London is not the Spanish flu. It is transmitted through the blood via violent biting, turning survivors into frenzied immortals. I am Dr. Jonathan Reed. I am a vampire, born anew into an age of death and pestilence. While plotting factions close in around me, I am sworn to find the source of this epidemic. I am convinced greater perils are still to come. I know the answers I seek are hiding in our blood.
Dr. Reed, welcome. How are you?
As good as one can be, considering the circumstances.
Yes. Death and affliction seem prevailing themes of late. Please, come in. We have much to discuss.
I hope I haven't disturbed you.
Not at all. Actually, I was counting on you visiting me tonight.
How strange, this painting. Beautiful, melancholic, yet with a haunting dignity.
Indeed. A long time ago, a friend asked me to paint this for him, but I kept it in the end.
I did not know you were a painter, my lady.
There are many things you do not know about me, young.
I must say, your house is exquisite.
One of the advantages of living forever is having the time to be selective with one's furnishings. I took the liberty of having tea served.
You can still drink tea.
Can't keep it down, but I do so enjoy the aroma. Let us toast and make believe. And of course, to your health, Jonathan.
And to yours, my lady.
Please, call me Elizabeth.
So, my lady, why, truly, did you invite me here?
I've been asked to deliver an official invitation to meet the Ascalon last great favor, and call me Elizabeth.
I should be honored, my lady.
Then it is settled. Finally, some good news in these dark hours.
Thank you. I appreciate the advice. I had best prepare myself to meet this Lord Redgrave now.
How thrilling. To meet the Earl of Bristol in the flesh, so to speak.
Something tells me you're not very keen on the man.
Don't get me wrong. The gentlemen of the Ascalon Club are honorable, but their attitude and opinions are somewhat antiquated.
I see.
As long as they deny access to female applicants, I will leave them to their antediluvian considerations as to the natural order of things. Jonathan, promise me you'll be careful.
Of course. But why the fear in your voice?
Look at me, Jonathan.
I am.
I mean, really look at me, young Ekon. We may be deceptive by nature, but this heart of mine has always told the truth.
Elizabeth.
Go, my friend. But come back to me soon.
Good evening. We repel the intruder once for now.
My good friends, if I may have your attention. Behold our visitor, the good Dr. Reed. Newborn of blood so pure and strong that even my friend Fergal Bansher was no match for him.
Hear, hear, hear!
Come forward, young Ekon, for we have so much to discuss. Welcome to the Ascalon Club, Dr. Reed. I am Lord Redgrave, Earl of Bristol and chairman of this exclusive association.
Lord Redgrave.
At last we meet. I've been eager to make your acquaintance. I've heard some astounding things about you. Please accept my condolences for your loss, Dr. Reed.
Thank you, my lord. Lady Ashbury expressed your wish to meet me.
Yes. The lady has always been a useful acquaintance, though not always reliable. Is she a good friend of yours?
Redgrave.
Godspeed, Dr. Reed. We are counting.
Who are you? You who dared enter my realm. Are you here to worship or mock me?
I'm here to put an end to the vampire epidemic, Miss Fletcher.
Ah, but Doris Fletcher is no more. She was consumed by this putrid flesh that now enshrouds her.
You feel anger for what happened to you, but I can help you. I'm a doctor, Miss Fletcher.
Doris Fletcher is no more. All that remains are the dreams of the queen she was. And the queen she'll be. Until then, all shall die, for that was her final wish.
Wait. I beg you, wait.
What?
I don't want to die.
And I did not come to kill you, Miss Fletcher.
Will you spare me, then? Save this cadaverous carcass of mine. Does your heart beat a little faster now? You fancy me, then, Doctor?
No, Miss Fletcher. My dead heart will beat for only one.
Ah! Is she pretty? Is she sweet and tender?
To me, yes.
Ah! I hate her already.
I know. And this is partly why you must be destroyed.
But you just said...
that I did not come here to kill you, yes. But I realize now the threat you embody must be stopped.
Will I be remembered? Will you?
You were Doris Fletcher, the greatest actress of her generation. No one can take that from you.
Thank you. And farewell.
Farewell, Doris.
Bravo! So dramatic. I love it.
McCullum.
How strange I seem to find you whenever I'm inquiring about that Skaal infestation.
I mean you no harm.
I'm not here for you. But once I put all the pieces of the puzzle together, I'm sure we'll have a little chat, you and me.
Stay away from me, McCullum. You and all your war dogs.
That I can't guarantee, Dr. Reed. But I'll let you go. For now.
Finally you're here, Dr. Reed. What took you so long?
I had to pass several of your barricades and outposts to access your mansion, sir.
Death, pestilence surround us, and time is against me.
I see you've gathered some of the most expensive, albeit experimental, blood transfusion equipment available. All this could be so useful in a hospital.
Yes, yes. Since Lord Redgrave sent me a doctor to perform my conversion, I thought you might find some of these devices useful.
Most thoughtful. But tonight, I'm not here as a physician.
But I feel reassured that a specialist such as yourself would help me to escape the Reaper.
Very well. But before I proceed, I have a few questions.
If you must, but be quick, for I don't have much time left in this life.
First of all, I need to be sure that you know exactly what is going to happen to you, sir.
I can assure you I'm as informed as any man can be. I have planned for this moment, Dr. Reed. Planned very...
Listen to me, Aloysius Dawson. You will forget your fear of dying, for it has poisoned your mind and made you bitter and ruthless since the death of your twin brother.
You don't understand. Death is oblivion, the eternal void. I know there's nothing there. I saw it in Robert's empty eyes. I saw myself in that coffin.
Death is painful for those who remain, not for those who have passed. All that occult gibberish you filled your head with has made you forget this simple truth.
No! Death will not claim me. I have the power and the money. I've acquired the arcane knowledge needed. I believe there is magic. There are dark forces. You will provide me my extension.
Your ignorance makes you a fool. You have no idea. Look at me. Hunted like a beast. My family lost. Cursed. I have not escaped death. I have become it.
No, there must be a way. I don't want to go like my brother did. I have money. Lots of money.
Money won't ease your mind. I know you used to be a good and generous man. So I offer you the gift of peace, Aloysius. The tranquility of a true death.
I accept your offer. And I understand. No more fear, I will die a man of dignity. And a man at peace.
Is it done, Dr. Reed? Is Aloysius Dawson reborn as expected?
I'm afraid Mr. Dawson finally chose to embrace life and death as a mortal.
What do you mean?
He has overcome his fear of dying. I let him rest and wait for death to come.
What? This is unacceptable. Go back there and make him the powerful Ekon he's destined to be.
No, Lord Redgrave. As a doctor and as an immortal, I can't. If you wish to make him your progeny, then proceed on your own.
This is an outrage beyond words. This is betrayal, pure and simple. I should kill you on the spot. You swore on William Marshall's blood.
Well, get rid of me then.
From now on, you're an outcast. Banished. You are forbidden to ever appear in front of us again. Ascalon will smite you on sight, and your heart will be thrown to the rats.
I'll leave you then. Have fun with your puppets and shadow plays, Lord Redgrave.
Yes, go, traitor, and take that awful creature, that counterfeit of a woman I saw waiting for you, and be gone!
What good fortune brings you back to me, Jonathan? What is it, my dear?
I'm afraid it's bad news, Elizabeth. The worst, actually.
Please, speak up.
Edgar is no longer in McCullum's grasp. I resolved that matter.
Where is our good friend now? Is he well?
He was mortally wounded. I put an end to his misery.
That is terrible, Jonathan. And yet you did what you must. The poor man.
Edgar Swansea was responsible for the Skull epidemic, Elizabeth. It was he who unleashed the deadly scourge upon London.
What? Are you certain? This is the most terrible accusation of all.
He confessed everything to me. He sought to cure the disease, to
all those poor... I must say I'm...
Yes.
Then we have...
I have one.
There is a term...
It was your blood Edgar used for his experiment on Harriet Jones.
What? No. No.
right?
No, I have to go.
What do you mean?
Leave me alone. Save the city, Jonathan. Save what can be saved.
Elizabeth, I need answers. Why did your blood
cause
this?
Stay away from me. Please. I swear I never was your
enemy.
Wait.
No! Elizabeth! Lungan has been cleansed. This catastrophe came about when an ancient malignant will crossed paths with mortal imprudence. For now, we are safe. For now, my craving for blood remains. Red like hate, red like hunger, red as life and death, passing from one immortal to another, from predator to victim, patiently biding its time to rise again. London has been cleansed for now, but there's a simmering hatred, fear, and old grudges. When will we succumb, mortals and immortals alike? The next disaster is only a matter of time. My only hope now is to catch the woman I love, to understand why she fled, and unmask the secret that has been lurking in her blood for so long. Well, this is it. Lady Ashbury's domain. Why am I not surprised it's not on any maps? I'd better hurry.
Drop your swords, father. You have nothing to be afraid of.
Shall we abandon this then? Shall we lower our heads?
No. Never. You taught me that.
Blood is approaching. Old but young. How strange. Shall I drink it? Smite it?
No, father. He is a friend. Please, rest. I'll take care of it.
Caution, Elizabeth. Deceit runs through these veins.
I know, father. What took you so long, Jonathan?
Is this really him?
Yes. This is William Marshall, 1st Earl of Pembroke. Servant of 5 mortal kings, former regent and savior of England. The greatest knight who ever lived, according to some.
And you called him father?
For he gave me eternal life, and much more.
I have so many questions, Elizabeth.
You always had questions, Dr. Reed.
Now that I stand before you both, in this vault, I know not where to begin.
We still have a few minutes left.
You told me.
No, Jonathan. The William Marshall myth lies at the heart of so many hostile plans. I could not risk jeopardizing his safety.
So why did you come here? You knew I would follow you. I can't let you go.
Because I know now the blood of hate is still in my veins. No one but I can put an end to this tragedy.
I can help you. You can trust me, Elizabeth.
Not always, Jonathan. I remember how you killed that poor nurse for blackmailing me.
Would your protege agree to speak with me? I have so many questions for him.
Go on, Jonathan. But be careful. Sir
William. My God. You really are William Marshall. You served Richard the Lionheart and his brother, King John. It is such a privilege to meet you.
I did in my day. Come closer if you want to speak, for my hearing isn't what it used to be.
I think your hearing is fine, sir.
What is it you want, then?
You free. Let you out. Isn't that what you want?
I pray for the day I'll see the sky again. I have all but forgotten its colors. I could walk and do so many things beneath the stars. But I doubt it would be wise to release me.
Then will you stay here and repent?
Elizabeth told me it will not be long now. I cannot wait to feel the sweet caress of her hand on my cheek after so long as she releases me. Has the time come?
Yes, Father.
Why not unleash me then? To see the sky a final time.
You already are the sky, and all its stars.
I'm not defeated, for I welcome the sword you bear, for it is mine.
You were never defeated, my lord. Farewell, Father. And to you also, Jonathan.
What do you mean?
I can't stand what I've become. This healthy carrier, as you put it. The flames will purify the poison that runs in my veins.
No! I won't allow this to happen.
I am death. Jonathan, wherever I go, I can't stand it.
Who cares? We are vampires. We are death.
No, Jonathan. I won't bring another disaster into this world.
I can't lose you, Elizabeth. Even if it means putting the whole world at risk.
How can you say such an awful thing? Where is the Jonathan I once saved from a Skal in this abandoned factory?
I'm not that frightened man anymore. I've learned so much. Done so much.
I see. So there is nothing worth living for in this world anymore. Farewell, my love.
Farewell.
One prayer for the summoned, called by this song. Child born from darkness, whose path he must find. Now the song is sung and your path chosen. England is safe, the price paid most dear. But what do you care? You are the one who keeps killing. You've chosen your path, my fallen champion, like others before you. Prey to lust and desire, slave to the everlasting thirst. My queen sleeps once again, and I'll soon join her slumber. Until alas, she rises, woken by the hunger never fed.